main thing is the kids. They may see you coming from Rochdale, or myself coming from Bradford, coming from them areas, making it to the top, thinking, right, it's something that we can achieve and something that we can do. Played it before?
Pakistan last year. It was the first game back with crowds. So that was good fun. One Lanks game and then one junior game.
So the Hajj for myself was a lifetime experience. It's like you said, as yourself, you know that we've got to make Hajj once in your lifetime. And what we try to do as Muslims is follow that Abrahamic rituals of what was done back then. So this is now going back into history, into time, thousands of years ago, which has been passed on till now. So there's certain rituals that you do there. So like I said, there's a lot of walking, a lot of praying, but also what it teaches out there is making sure you're patient. But like I said, for me, this was the right time to go. You know, I've been wanting to go for past couple of years because of cricket. I've always found it a bit tricky. So this year, I spoke to the ECB, I spoke to my county Yorkshire, and they were 100% like, you know, go do what you need to do and come back into cricket. So for myself, it was quite easy to make that decision. Whereas maybe in the past, it was a bit tricky to actually say that, you know, because maybe they don't understand the whole situation. But once we explained it to them, they found it very easy to say yes.
The fact that I saw that you were able to do it and they allowed you to do it was actually a big step, because then for me, it's something that, like, hang on, I can actually, in a couple of years, I could actually go and do this, and then you don't feel bad about asking the question. You would have never thought about asking the question.
No, I would never thought about this five years ago. I never thought about that.
I remember when I first came into the dressing room, New Zealand, some of the boys I'd never met before, but there was just something about the dressing room where, even at the airport, when I first got there, you could just be yourself. And I remember where we just started praying in the airport. It's the fact that you and Mo have been there for the last however many years, and you've almost been around the boys, so they know, hang on, this is what these guys do and stuff. So for me, having never been a part of where I felt comfortable enough to go and do that.
Mine was a bit different, because I made my debut in 2009. The dressing room, the atmosphere, the whole environment was completely different. It isn't like what it is now.
That group is the best group I've been a part of.
100% without a doubt.
And for that reason, where you walk into a dressing room where you can be yourself, and then over time you grow as a person because you're being yourself instead of just trying to...
Well, that's really important, is to be yourself. Yeah. You want to identify yourself as you and not trying to do something that you're not comfortable with doing.
Yeah. So the test series against India last year, the Headingley test match, the day before Johnny Best, I invited everyone round to his for a barbecue. And me and Mo were sort of chatting, we go, right, we'll head down, just socialise with the boys a bit, but then we'll go, and obviously go get food and all of that. But Johnny sort of pulled us both over at training and said, all the meat was halal, he ordered no pork, none of that. So he was like, you know, I'd like it if you guys could come. And that actually meant a lot for me and Mo at the time.
100%.
Because it was someone's actually gone out of their way to do something to cater for us. And we actually went, stayed there the whole day, had a great day. And even something like that is, he knew what we needed, and he went out of his way to do something for us to make us feel part of the group. As little as things like when we've gone to grounds, so it happened to me a lot sort of growing up, where you'd go to grounds and you only eat halal food, but they don't have anything there. I remember being served a block of cheese once at a second team ground. Like that's the stuff you had to deal with, and you talk about that now and you try and tell that to a nutritionist with the amount of energy output you're having out there, and then what you get at lunch is a block of cheese with some cold pasta. Like, it's just...
Was it actually... It's definitely, like I said, moved on from then.
And it's starting to happen in the England dressing room, where we get looked after a lot, and hopefully stems down into county cricket and pathways.
So for the next generation, when they come in, they find it a lot easier.
So for us, we obviously will do our stuff here in the dressing room and around the game and all of that. But I actually haven't come to watch games at cricket grounds much, especially in the last few years. But now, knowing that, I think there's a prayer room in Lourdes as well now, there's prayer rooms at most grounds. the guys in Najm are obviously doing all of this work. For me, I think it's more accessible for people who come and watch. It's a lot easier to plan around.
Yeah.
Even the little things like that.
No, it also encourages families as well to come with their kids, and knowing that if they're here and it is prayer time, they've got somewhere to pray.
After games and around, away from cricket, is when you see parents with their kids. And
I think that's the main thing. The main thing is the kids, you know.
Yeah.
Like I said, they may see you coming from Rochdale, or myself coming from Bradford, a boy coming from them areas making it to the top. So they see that and thinking, right, it's something that we can achieve and something that we can do.